got him. He stared. Look. Look. Yeah. Full court press or full blitz, we going all out. It don't matter any time of day, I came to ball out. We TCG, never duck a smoker, any call out. Better be ready to go to war until we fall out. 0 to 60 like Ludacris, we came to roll out. You know I gotta get my checks, so please don't make me hold out. Bust down Cuban in the summer day, I make it cold out. They was hot then, now they cold.
This is the NFL on EA Sports, and football has returned to America's finest city, San Diego, California. Straight ahead, a clash to decide the AFC's representative in the Super Bowl, and it should be a great one, as it'll be the New York Jets taking on the Chargers of San Diego.
The winner here goes to the Super Bowl, and we'll know soon enough which team that'll be as we are underway in the AFC title game. Former ASU Sun Devil, Eno Benjamin with it. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. And he's going to have the hook up to Scott. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on 3rd down.
Herbert going to change the play here. On the ground, Benjamin. Through the middle of the field. He may go.
And all the way in. Touchdown, New York.
Eno Benjamin.
66 yards.
And the Jets are on the board first here in this AFC Championship game.
We see this a lot on 3rd and short yardage, especially down here in the red zone. They're going to sell out to stop the run, try and hold them to a field goal. But once the running back gets past the first wave, the resistance can evaporate after that. And he not only picks up the first, but he takes it all the way into the end zone.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
This fielded right at the goal line.
A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. They'll start this drive out on the ground.
And the defense closes quickly there. He'll get maybe a yard to the 33.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
19, Tiger.
They go play action with Richardson.
Wide open receiver complete. A big change in field position there. That's 40 yards on the catch and run.
And the offense is saying to itself right now, if only they were all this easy, because he was wide open. And once he made the catch, plenty of room to work his way downfield. That was a breakdown on the defensive side of the ball, one that they want to fix immediately.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, 1st and 10. One back in the backfield. He'll get the carry. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. The defense showing some anger after giving up the big play. This time they'll lose one or two.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Now Richardson. And he's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. They get to him for a loss of four. And it brings up third down on the sack. And they weren't in zone coverage. They were in man. And each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
So two plays with only negative yardage to show, and now it's third and 16. Richardson looking to throw this. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
I'm darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle. And the ball is still trailing at 7-3. So both teams come away with points on their opening drives, and they still trail. They answered the touchdown with a field goal, but at least able to break that goose egg here early.
And that is what's important, right? Because they didn't let that initial touchdown go unanswered. Took the ball themselves, moved it downfield, and put it through the post for 3 points. Game on.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Rashawn Slater, first-round pick in 2021, guilty there. So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a first and 20. Hands it off out of the gun. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
That was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just so quick, 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 and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Now it's Herbert. Complete. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They run it with Benjamin. There he goes, left side. And he's going to be shoved out, but not before he gets this down to the 20-yard line. 115 yards rushing for him now as he goes over the century mark here in this AFC title game. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. Herbert operating from the red zone. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense. They kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. A shotgun snap for Herbert. escaping the pressure right. And he wisely will throw that one away.
What a sequence there defensively. You get the sack that moved him to third and long. Then here, just nothing available. And he's got to throw it away.
Back to throw here, Herbert. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Scott. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the five. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Now Herbert going to change the look. Now a whistle and I think a penalty here for a delay. No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. He gets this down to the three, but no further. Brought the great move out of the bag, but couldn't do a ton with it. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Scott. Touchdown, Jets! Tyler Scott from 3 yards out. And they are able to add on to their advantage. Extra point attempt here still to come. This one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
For most people, the excitement of a kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder into ball carrier, and down he goes.
The Charger drive about to get going. They've got to be a little shell-shocked. Down double digits at home in the playoffs. Still in the first half, they've got to turn things around quickly. 2 yards on the carry there, it'll be second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
This is second and 8. Back to throw. Here's Richardson. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Well, hang on now. We're going to pause here. We've got an injured player. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment.
In it to win it.
Got it.
Third and 3. And Richardson back to throw it. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Andrew Booth picks it off. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. So more problems here in this first quarter. Already 2 scores down, and here they give away the football.
And if I'm the head coach, I think it's time to start lighting a fire under some of these guys. Now, you have to do it within your personality. They can't perceive it as fake. But I'd go get after some guys because they don't look ready to play to me. They look flat, uninspired. It's time to get moving.
Baylor Tiger.
After the turnover, here's Herbert. Throws right side, and that's complete. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. A good pickup there, 26 yards. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
They hold him to only two there on the screen. It's second down. Herbert now. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. And the Chargers are going to get possession of the football as time will run out on this first quarter of play. After one, a 14-3 ball game. Charger drive about to get going. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit, in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Yeah, quick throw here, that's complete. Yeah, they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Tally, that is catch number one for him in this AFC Championship. It's a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
So they cite the right guard this time with a holding penalty.
And so many different assignments you can have at that position, and sometimes you might just be a step too late and have to grab and hold on.
Ready, check. Check it. Let's go.
Richardson. Oh, he stays up. Flushed out right. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. They get 14 yards, but not enough for the first down due to the previous penalty.
No surprise to see him running again here is something he's done throughout this season. And that run puts him over 500 yards on the ground for the year. He's got to be thinking to himself, if I'm already at 500, what's to stop me from going for 1,000?
Richardson to throw off play action. The throw here right sideline falls incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well and that one's incomplete.
So the incomplete pass on the last play and that leads us to a 3rd and 3.
Dragon 60.
Richardson working from the gun. That is caught. And he is going to have the Chargers first down, I do believe. Yes, he's got it by about a yard there on 3rd and 3.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. 3rd and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
An opening there on that first down run as he gets this forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so 2nd and 2.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
Ball on the 39. Here's 2nd down and 2. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up 3rd down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
And on 3rd and 5, this will be the 8th play of the drive. Here's Richardson to throw. Pass taken in. Ball's been tied in. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 26. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first.
Normally on 3rd down and short yardage, you're thinking of throwing to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field. And a nice dart picks up the first down and then some.
On 1st down, they'll go to the ground attack. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Richardson looking to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. 2nd catch of this AFC title game, and he's got a 1st down.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you got to run fast. Of course, you got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, there's a premium for all of that now.
It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be 2nd and goal.
This is a critical sequence here for this offense. Things really haven't gone their way so far. This could be their chance to get back into it, but they've got to find a way to punch this ball in.
2nd and goal from inside the 5. They'll try again. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Chargers. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Chargers have cut it back within a score. Point after, right down the middle. Makes it a 14-10 ball game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. In a close game like this, Charles, those interceptions like they had on the last drive could be costly, but here they've got another opportunity to seize control of this game.
And they better take advantage of it, because otherwise, if they end up losing by 1 score, they'll relive this over and over and over until they have another opportunity to wipe it away.
A play fake, and now Herbert to throw. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A big play that time on the catch and run. And the Jets are going to get a new set of downs. This is Benjamin. And nothing much materializing there on the 1st down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it. From the 46, here's the 2nd and 8. Herbert. On the throw, let him too much that time. It's incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. that's where the first down marker is here on third. Here's Herbert. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Sometimes the game is pretty simple. Put a few extra defensive backs on the field, give them nowhere to throw the football, force the incompletion, and get off the field on third down.
Blake Gillikin on the punt now on fourth down. Then how about this, a fake? And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. The Charger drive about to get going.
The long drive last time out for this offense, Charles, if you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now. But let's give credit where it's due, because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football.
AFC title game, second quarter action, 2 minutes to play. A reminder, as we did all through the regular season, we'll check in with Jonathan Coachman at halftime. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
Ready,
now three. Second and five. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. It goes as a loss of six. And now third down.
This defense has really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
What do they have for this? Third and 11. Now it's Richardson. They're going to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight end, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds him for the first down.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up.
So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good and some bad, because they did give up the touchdown run to him early, but shut him down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well.
And here's a handoff out of the gun. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. And the Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. They need to get to the 29 if they want to pick up a first here on third down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. Touchdown! A great effort there. 36 yards. And the Chargers have taken the lead here in this AFC title game. That could be an important swing right there. Touchdown in the final minute of the half to take the lead.
And I like the point you just made there. Could be an important swing, because now that they have the lead, if they can carry that into the locker room at the half, they'll feel really good about what they accomplished in the first two quarters.
Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now 17-14. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And he'll elect not to run with it. The fair catch will move this out to the 25-yard line.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
A good pickup there, a 22.
And that's a good start right there. This game's changed pretty dramatically in the last few minutes. So now these guys are forced to play from behind here. And that's a positive first step towards claiming this lead right back.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Justin Herbert looking to pass. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Second down, here's Herbert. And he's got his big tight end here. The Jets going to go ahead and use their final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he's got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Come up now, third and three. Play action. It's Herbert. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. And that will tie things at 17-all. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
The Charger drive about to get going. 1 second, all that remains. A final shot before the half, Richardson. Looking left sideline, it's complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. One more half to decide who takes home the Lamar Hunt Trophy as we're back underway in this AFC Championship. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29. The Charger drive about to get going. And CD, we are in for a very intriguing second half. This is what we wanted, all tied. This is what postseason football is all about.
It certainly is. And doesn't it speak to the parity in the NFL? Roughly half the teams that made the playoffs a year before miss the next year, get replaced. We know it's an any given Sunday mentality. Nothing's easy in the playoffs, but when you have your shot, they're eager to seize it.
Now second and nine. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Richardson hit and he fumbles it. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. And now, meanwhile, after the dust settles on the fumble, we've got an injured player here as well. The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And a strong run there as he'll maneuver his way down inside the 15. A Jet first down, 18 big yards that time. Good push up front and that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they were able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert rolling to his right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
And in the second half of a tied game, every decision gets magnified. And here, if he forces this ball, it could be intercepted. So that's the prudent play to just airmail it out of bounds.
Here's second and 10. One down to about the 10-yard line. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
Shotgun. Here's Herbert. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Now the Jets will call on a field goal unit here. This is a 27-yard attempt here. And his kick is good. And with that, they take the lead here 20-17. So they wind up turning the turnover into points as they convert there for three.
Yeah, that was a nice job there to force the fumble. They recover, hand things over to their offense, and then the offense went down and got them three. That alone, that's not enough to win a game, but both units able to do their jobs on these last two drives.
And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Charger drive about to get going. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they were able to give up the field goal and they were able to
trot back out on the field to start this drive. A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
Second and 10. Richardson out of the shotgun.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Tough series for the passing game. Things just aren't clicking. Hoping they can come through on this play and get this series back on track with a completion for enough yardage for a first down.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. Richardson looking to throw this. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked by Chad Moomer.
And he brings this one back. It's a pick six and a Jet touchdown.
Well, CD, we have seen it many times throughout the course of the season. This defense coming up large and snagging a big takeaway. But here they get not just the takeaway, 6 points as well.
And you just knew that for this team to advance, it had to get a big performance from this unit. And to this point, they've delivered.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone.
And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, we were having a tough patch. This too shall pass, this too shall pass. And it finally kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert.
And now a fumble. The ball's out.
Oh, and this one, him may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's run well.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Come 19!
Second down, here's Richardson.
And the Jets pressure too much as down he goes. It'll go as a loss of about six, and now it brings up third.
And you get the feeling, Charles, yeah, he's got the two sacks now, but he may get more here. We still got a quarter and then some to go.
And the way that he is playing this game, it reminds me of one of the best golfers in the world who can use every club in the bag and make a great shot.
Richardson hit and he fumbles it. Second time in this game, Charles, the ball is squirted out from his hands. Luckily, his teammate was there to pounce on it.
You're right. Got the lucky bounce, able to retain possession. You know, we often talk about the combine and why do we measure quarterbacks' hands. Is that really a big deal? It's for situations like this. Do you have the hands big enough and strong enough to hold on to the football while being jostled?
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. A very good punt, but a 16-yard return. And the Jets will take over first and 10.
Oh.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. On first down, they'll go to the ground attempt. He'll get this down to the 38. And now they're in the hurry up.
Brian Brzee on the stop. 2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight at the 38-yard line.
Hey, Ray.
Here, they'll give him another shot here on the ground. There he goes, left side. And they will finally drag him down at the Chargers' 6-yard line. He had his eyes on the end zone once he hit the secondary, but they're finally able to slow him down.
Yeah, and I've got to look at this one from the defensive point of view. You just mentioned finally able to slow him down. They've got to figure out a way to make that at the point of attack, at the line of scrimmage, because once he gets through, he's shredding them.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4.
All of a sudden, those lanes that were there earlier in the drive dry up near the goal line. That's a good job defensively to diagnose the run and stop it for a very short pickup.
Second and goal from inside the 5. They'll try the air now with Herbert. And this will be caught. In the end zone, touchdown, Jets. Tyler Scott, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jets add 6 to their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. The Jets kick team out now to boot this one away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. And it appears we have a Charger shaken up on that last play. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. The Charger drive about to get going. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
AFC Championship tilt, third quarter of play. This is second and 10. There, they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he loses the football a second time. Oh, and one of the linemen on the other side has got it. And his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. And great effort. Does he get burned for that in film? He fought through some tackles. End result, though, a fumble.
It's going to be one of those situations where he'll get yelled at about the fumble, but at the same time get a check mark for the extra effort. And so it's one of those tough, tricky things for coaches. You don't want to coach it out of them so much that you take away the effort. You just want them to be conscious of taking care of them.
Oh, the turnover fest continues. Here's another interception. This one back. It's a pick six and a Charger TD. Boy, a big play right there. I mean, a touchdown on this drive could have really put some separation on the scoreboard. Instead, it's the defense who scores. And, partner, we got a game again.
And we do have one because of what you just described, a defense that understood what was going on in this game and did something about it. They knew their offense needed some help. They just provided it. They're back in this one.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
Running game working, they'll stick with it on first down. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers 33. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down. So from Charger territory now, here's a first and 10 down at the 33. Hands it off out of the gun. And a strong run there as he'll maneuver his way down inside the 15. 41 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times.
And that's the kind of run you get when you know Super Bowl berth is in sight. They've got the lead. It's the second half. All those weeks of wear and tear in your body just go away. He's running with purpose now, and that's a heck of a run.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it, but what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 3rd down.
This has been an up-and-down, back-and-forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive took a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settled things down a little bit.
This offense so far on 3rd down, they've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. Here it's 3rd and 2. And he will find Scott on the right side complete. Touchdown, Jets! Tyler Scott saving his best for the playoffs with his 3rd touchdown of the game. And the Jets are closing in on a Super Bowl berth now as they extend their 4th quarter lead. A try here for the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The Charger drive about to get going. And their dream of a Super Bowl berth so close 3 quarters ago, but obviously starting to slip away if it hasn't already. They need points here and in a hurry. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That one goes for 36 yards.
Well, this game has certainly had no shortage of offense. Both teams have been revved up from the start. And here's yet another big play. Boy, both defenses have just got to be dragging out.
On Herbert, his third interception. Picked off by A.J. Terrell. And the Jets are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line. So the holding call on the offense, so they go ahead and decline that one and take possession of the football on the INT. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And a short pickup to about the 27. It'll be second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard.
Now that's a nice play. Got me fired up, partner. But can they do it back-to-back plays? All the training that you go through as a defense for these situations, when you have to get the ball back, everything you go through, holding up the runner, raking at the football, getting to the passer, knocking it out of his hands, whatever way, they have to get the ball back.
Now can they stand tall again for a huge fourth quarter stop? Here's a short one to the tight end, Johnson. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
And this third down looking very tough after the holding penalty. 3rd and long. Now it's Herbert. Looking deep here for Dobbs. And that's caught inside the 30. It's a big play there for the Jets on 3rd down. 59 yards.
And even with the game seemingly in hand, they're continuing to fire away, pressing the ball down the field. Listen, it's worked all day. No reason to go away from it now.
So it's Jets football as we get you reset here. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. On 1st down, they'll go to the ground attack. They follow up that gigantic gain with the tiniest of pickups, 1 yard.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
So 7 yards from the 1st down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. And here's a handoff out of the gun. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. 83 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it at them. We've got them now.
The Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. They're going to pass here with Herbert. Flush to his right, and the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. So they'll accept that penalty, and that'll, of course, move the football up the field. The defense can stop it twice more as they take a knee here. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 25 ticks remaining on the clock. And they will take a knee here. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And they take a knee. And as they take that knee, you can hear a pin drop in this stadium right now, partner.
I'd say you could hear a pin drop except for one thing. You're hearing a lot of people on cell phones right now calling and saying, cancel my reservation, because this crowd thought they were going to the Super Bowl. They had trips planned, hotels, reservations, the whole deal. That's all wiped out now.
And well, they could just run this clock out, but here is the field goal unit on fourth down. This from 25 yards out. And the kick is good. So you wonder how this one might be remembered the next time these two teams meet. But until then, this game's over. And with this win and an AFC championship, they have reached the most hallowed ground in all of sports.
That means they are the best in their conference. What an incredible feeling for this team to go through the entire season and come out on top and now go to the Super Bowl for the right to be called world champion.
And that'll close the books on the conference championship for Charles Davis.
Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step by me? Who gon' step by me?
Yeah, told him I would be a boss before I had business. I don't even need nobody here to vouch. I was all alone, so I ain't have a witness. Right back to the lab. Gotta go to work, I'm revving up my engine. I was just putting groceries in the bag. Now wait a minute, yeah, forgot to mention. I'm $100 million richer. Might paint $100 million picture. One man army, but I don't fatigue. Better have $100 million coming with you. Got good karma, so I'm riding fiscal. Hit the crossover, leave them playing Twister. Or they thought that I was just a... Now when I do, they call me mister. Stop it. Big wall with some ice. Play with the family, playing with your life. Just got the ops hurt, looking sick. So we gon' disinfect them like a wipe. Had that boy a big cat with no stripes. Now on the gram, ain't worried about a light. Yeah, I had to go ahead and raise the fee. If you ain't rocking with it, take a hike.
Say you gon' ride. Say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide. Say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step by me? Who gon' step by me? Say you gon' ride. Is he gon' step by me? Can't do it back, keep racks on me. Name him with, I keep three on me. Oh,
so you ride it. I can do everything that you gon' like. Young, rich, and famous, I'm living the life. Uh-oh, pull up in that new thing. I'm swerving and hogging the both lanes. You know I'm in the mood. After I score, I'ma bring it to you. Then free.